This is your neighborhood friendly ranter speaking, bringing you another edition of Asian Movie Madness. Now, I'm going to try and jump right into today's film as quickly as possible because really I could talk about it all day. So, without further ado, today's film is Cold Fish. Now, this is directed by one of my favorite Asian cinema directors, Sion Sono, who did work on Suicide Club and Strange Circus. The basic plotline here is that Mr. Shimoto's life is turned upside down by an exotic fish dealer who basically kills people to get whatever he wants. And it's sort of the chronicle of Shimoto's descent into madness as he is pushed over the edge. What you'll really notice the most about this film, as far as from someone's perspective who's watched Sion Sono's films before, is that this particular film is way more focused than any of Sono's other works. While Strange Circus was good, it sort of lacked any kind of real driving narrative, and it sort of lacked any kind of true point to the story. It was just sort of a disturbing, surrealistic journey. And I feel like Suicide Club, while it started out with a pretty decent narrative, didn't really follow through all that well. But this particular film strikes me on so many levels because not only is it a social commentary, but it's very much a commentary on people's inner psychology. Because this movie truly asks the questions that I believe our society really needs to ask themselves. Because with our society being as sort of pacifistic and nonviolent and repressed as it is, I feel like that's sort of breeding this very, very psychologically unstable society. And this sort of asks the question, how far will you let things go before you actually stand up for yourself? Before you actually say no to somebody? You know, how far will your pacifism get you? What if someone wants to take everything from you? Are you going to give them everything? And it really makes you ponder on your own personal view of this. Because what happens to Shimoto is very, very horrifying. And the way it happens is very unsettling. It shocks you into basically looking at this and going, I would not stand for that. I would call the police. I would stand up and fight this guy. I would not let him push me around like that. And that's really something that most movies, especially in today's society, never do. They never talk to you on a level that you can really relate to, or a level that will really challenge who you are. And it also strikes me as a very good psychological analysis, because Shimoto is this very repressed, very stoic, you know, almost stereotypical Japanese man. And as he is pushed by this bully, all of a sudden this dark nature within him starts to reveal itself. And it's very, very unsettling to watch Shimoto sort of explode and, you know, become this man that's basically completely the opposite of the man you see in the first half of the film. And I think that's something that's very lost on horror films in general, is that they're not very horrifying. You know, there's also plenty of gore there to keep, you know, the gorenography fans happy. But at the same time, the film delves far deeper than just some sort of hack and slash Saw type of movie. This is a shining example of what horror movies should be. While Jason and Freddy are very, very entertaining, they just don't sate my appetite for a truly horrific movie. And this movie does. And I think that's something truly special that should be recognized. So my recommendation is not only to check this movie out, but to buy it. Put it in your collection, because this is truly a movie that needs to be recognized. So that is my review of Cold Fish.